Number three. This is an interesting one. So whether it's in business or in life, sometimes you get the opportunities. Now, I did very well in my field, but sometimes you get the opportunity to speak with or negotiate with or do business with people that have produced even more and done even bigger things.
Yeah.
So my question to you is this. Picture yourself, switch it over to you now. If you had the chance, which you may have already, speak with like Michael Jordan, let's say. How do you get your mindset up for that? How do you get your mindset right so that you have the ability and the power to speak with someone like that?
So for me, first of all, this is what I think. I really do believe, you know, in the law of attraction, in that if I'm connected with somebody, and I was thinking about LeBron this week because I worked for Dan Gilbert.
Wow.
So in my mind, I'm thinking every year I speak to the Cleveland Cavaliers. So in my mind, I'm like, you know, I'm not really sure, you know, because they have LeBron now, I'm not really sure if Dan Gilbert will bring me in and ask me to do, you know, what I've done traditionally for the team. I'm not sure. But if he does, it is only an extension of what we've done. So, like, when you meet somebody that, you know, you're like, wow, that person is very successful. So I figure when I'm in the room with LeBron, I figure that as a speaker, I am on that same level as a LeBron James. I don't play basketball, but what I do in my gift. And so I believe that we're in the same room together because...
You're the LeBron of speaking.
Yeah. Mutually, we have something to offer one another. And so I definitely come to offer LeBron. Well, first of all, LeBron says in SportsCenter that he used the when you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, you know, to get that first title.
Wow.
So now it's like, okay, LeBron, you lost one miserably. You come into a new team with new guys, so you definitely can learn from me. You know, so then I feel like with LeBron, it will be better than even Michael Jordan because for LeBron, you have heard me speak. So from what you know about me and what you know it takes to get to the top and be the best you could be, what would be your recommendations for me? You know, like, what would you say to somebody, you know, in my particular shoes? You know, because you are a person of excellence. So knowing that I might be, you know, people are saying, you might be the top five, or in some people's category, you might be top 10, you know? And so it's like LeBron, they're saying I'm top 10, the top five, you were number one. What do you think you did to become number one, and what could you offer me? What could you say to me? So when I get in the room with them, I think one of the beautiful things for me, and I think the reason why I've been able to meet so many different people and minister to so many different people is because I go into the room not cocky or arrogant at all, but an understanding of who I am, an understanding that I have worked hard. I have put in 10,000 hours. You know, I am serious about what I'm doing. You know, I have. And so while I'm not saying you owe me anything, I'm saying that I've earned the right to be in this room. And because I've earned the right to be in this room, I'm asking you to genuinely speak to me where I am and help me get to that next level. So I'm not in the room as a fan, you know, or a groupie. You know, I'm not in this room as somebody who's overwhelmed. I'm grateful for the opportunity. I'm grateful that I had a chance to really meet you in a different form, you know, where I can sit down and talk like what we're doing. Man, 200 people in the room.
Yeah.
Nobody did what you did.
Yeah.
Nobody was that genius. You know, and for real, my clients that I work with pay thousands and thousands of dollars for me to life coach them. But for me, I was intrigued, like, yo, my man's serious, like, that's a power move, what he just did. It's not even about the money for me. You know, it was about, yo, my man's serious about his life. He's serious about his career. And he wasn't just one of those people in the room that wanted my autograph. That was just kind of like, oh, he thought enough of himself to say, yo, for real, E, if you got some time, you know, I would love to be able to pick your brain to just say I talked to E.T., but you could get off the phone and say, man, I just got a nugget that's going to revolutionize my life and help me to get to the next level. So that the same way you did to me is what I'm feeling with LeBron. Like, yo, I'm trying to get to another level, and you have got two levels. What can you say to somebody like me that's trying to do exactly what you're trying to do?
Wow.